Beaton Mirror Now. Just yesterday, the police in Pune arrested Ravindra Marathe, the current serving CEO of the Bank of Maharashtra, along with former chairman, executive director and several other bank officials for apparently colluding with the real estate developer D.S. Kulkarni to divert money and to cheat shareholders. Apparently, these bank officers colluded to give Mr. Kulkarni a loan against the business that was actually used to renovate his home. Now, this would not be the first team of bank officials who colluded to cheat and steal money. Remember Nirav Modi and the 13,000 crore rupees? Now, we were earlier told that this was the doing of two single employees, fairly low down in the pecking order and one single branch, making it sound like a one-off incident. But just today, details from the bank's own internal 162-page probe report tells us that no less than 50 employees colluded over several years to allow Nirav Modi to get away. According to this report, and this is going to be really interesting, according to this report, Punjab National Bank officials ranging from the clerk to the foreign exchange managers to the auditors, the heads of regional offices, 54 of them altogether, are to be collectively blamed for this colossal loss to the bank and to the country. The bank's international banking department and its IT division even delayed making their integration work complete in order to allow this scam to happen. So how do they expect us to believe that nobody knew of this? The Brady House branch in Mumbai, the branch from where this entire scam was masterminded and headquartered, sent only 2 out of 12 of its monthly reports last year to its regional office. But the regional office issued a compliance certificate nevertheless. None of the senior inspection officers reported anything adverse. The bank's import-export transactions went up 50% in 2017, and nobody in the bank even bothered to look into it, let alone investigate. In the weeks before his retirement, Gokulnath Shetty, the prime accused, used his personal email ID to reconcile massive forex transactions involving Nirav Modi, and this was completely overlooked by the bank's treasury department. Under the Punjab National Bank policy, no officer is to remain in one office or one branch for more than 3 years because they don't want that officer to form comfortable relations like Gokulnath had with Nirav Modi. But Gokulnath Shetty stayed at the Brady House branch for 7 years. Now that is impossible to do unless the PNB top management was in the know and was aiding and abetting. The other question we must ask is, can the RBI here claim complete innocence? The chief vigilance officer of Punjab National Bank emailed the RBI asking for a special investigation to be conducted off that Brady House branch, and that email was ignored as well. What's worse, the scams right now are rampant and chronic and not just limited to the public sector. ICICI Bank, our second largest private sector bank, is currently dealing with an accusation against its CEO Chanda Kochar, who's being investigated. Over the last 5 years, 23,000 bank frauds worth 1 lakh crore rupees have been reported. And who is the watchman who is napping on the job? According to the Banking Regulations Act, the RBI officers have the authority to inspect any bank at will, to call for special audits of any bank, and to order changes in management if they're uncomfortable with what is going on in the bank. So the question I ask tonight is this: has the RBI completely abdicated its responsibility of keeping our money safe? Joining me on the show,